16 minutes to 2 at BBC Newcastle, Radio for the North East. Now, Alfie Boe. I think it's fair to say he's not your average common garden singer. The youngest of nine from a working-class Lancashire family, he forged his way into a world that wasn't really ready for Alfie Boe and managed to ruffle a few feathers along the way. Alfie brings his spectacular stage show, Trust, to Newcastle at the end of this month, and I caught up with him for a chat. He explained to me how it all began. Alfie Boe.
It's just, it's crazy, crazy story. I don't, you know, and one thing, I don't really call myself an opera singer anymore because I'm singing lots of different styles of music.
Yes.
So it's a funny one. I don't see any division between them. But my break really came about when I was working in a car factory and I was singing along to the radio, and a guy overheard me singing and told me that I should try and do something with it, you know, and go and audition for this company in London that he knew about, and he told me where to go, and I came down to London, auditioned, sang to them and got taken on, and I've been singing ever since, really.
In your autobiography last year, Alfie, My Story, you talk openly about your struggles to be accepted in this world, this new world, the car mechanic with the northern accent. How do you feel about those same people now?
They're great colleagues. I mean, they were lovely people to work with, and I was accepted a lot to an extent in certain areas. But I really came along into the industry not thinking that I would be put in any box or you know, but it just inevitably happened at some point.
People,
you know,
don't they? People,
yeah, they do.
We love
they
to do that in this country.
Exactly. That's really why I don't call myself an opera singer anymore, because I feel it gives me a title and sort of limits me to what I can do. You know, I want to sing a lot of different styles of music and a lot of different things, so I don't really want to be known as an opera singer singing rock and roll. I want to just be known as a singer.
It must be very hard not to be smug, Alfie.
I hope I'm not smug. I hope I don't come across like that. But no, I'm grateful for everything that's happening for me now, and I don't really look back on my time and say, "See, I told you so."
Yes,
I don't look at it like that, because it was all a training process. It was a learning process. I learned a lot. I learned how to deal with the ups and downs and get on with it and move forward. So I don't really hold it against anybody, really, because it was something I had to learn from.
You're going on tour, aren't you? The Trust Tour.
The Trust Tour, yes. The main song off the album is called Trust. And all the songs have an element of trust to them as well, you know, on the album. So it's
I think you're opening the tour in Newcastle, actually, aren't you?
I am. Yes, I love Newcastle. Mm. We have such a great time there. Last year it was a fantastic show to play. It was freezing, and I can't believe how little the ladies were wearing in the streets.
That's incredible. What they always say, isn't it? And people don't believe it until they've seen it for themselves.
I know, I thought Blackpool was bad, but no, my goodness, Newcastle. It was great, man. No, it was wonderful. I didn't know where to look.
I bet. Alfie Boe on the puzzling clothing habits of many a Geordie lass. Let's have some more with Alfie next. BBC Newcastle, Radio for the North East. On the 29th of November, Alfie Boe plays at the same venue, at the arena in Newcastle. I've been chatting to Alfie Boe. We had a very interesting talk, and as you will hear after 2 o'clock, our chat took on something of a sinister turn. Seriously, it actually freaked me out, what he had to say. Hear that after 2 o'clock, and a bit more with Alfie Boe in just a second. So, yes, Alfie Boe. I don't know if you saw him on the Remembrance Day concert the other day. Just fabulous. Really, really good. And now he's packing them into arenas at the Newcastle Arena on the 29th of November. I asked him, what can we expect from the show? Surely he'll have to do something from Les Mis.
Songs.
Not just opera.
Not just opera. No, there'll be lots of different things. There'll be a little bit of Neapolitan classic stuff, you know, Neapolitan folk songs. There'll be at the minute it's a little early. I mean, the majority of the songs will be off the Trust album. You know, there'll be a few of the older songs as well that I've done in the past, and maybe some new ones that are an indication of the direction that we'll be investigating for the future, you know, that sort of thing. But just at the moment, the Trust album is the basis of the show. You know, that'll be what the show will be about, really, is that album.
Are there certain songs, Alfie Boe, that people expect you to sing?
Some people think that they come along to my concerts and they'll expect an evening of classical repertoire of operatic arias, but I do like, in a way, of giving them that element of surprise and singing something that they wouldn't have expected me to sing. Well, for example, I said at one show, I said, ladies and gentlemen, I'm a huge Queen fan, and it's Freddie Mercury's birthday coming up, and I would like to do a dedication and sing one of his beautiful songs. I said, can anybody guess what it's going to be? Everybody shouted out, Bohemian Rhapsody, Bohemian Rhapsody, sing Bohemian Rhapsody.
That would be difficult to sing, wouldn't it? Just
it
by
would
yourself.
Be, I mean, you know, full parts.
Can all. You imagine?
And I said, sing Bohemian Rhapsody. So I said, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, this is just for you. And I sang Fat Bottom Girls.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Excellent. And everyone was like, oh, we didn't see that one coming.
We didn't, no, exactly. So I like to keep people on the toes.
Of course, that week that you're in Newcastle, on the 29th, that will be, I think, the anniversary of Freddie Mercury's death, won't it?
He was such a legend to me, and such a an inspiration. You know, his performance on stage just blew me away. It was incredible to see that guy sing and perform. And he was one of the reasons why I wanted to do what I do now, I think, you know.
Do you think that in the same way that you remember Freddie Mercury in that electrifying performance, that, you know, you're going out there, you're doing it now, and people will be saying the same thing about you?
Well, that's very nice of you to say. I hope I am sort of inspiring some younger performers out there that'll go on and fulfil their dreams. That's nice to think.
Well, without doubt. I mean, you are, aren't you?
Well, I hope so. That's very nice of you to say. I do get some lovely letters from young kids saying how much they're affected by my performance and that my music, which is a real bonus, because that's really what I'm doing it for. It's for the fans. It's for the guys out there that buy the albums and listen to my music. It's really all about them, really. I want to just give them good entertainment, good music to listen to, and give them a sense of emotion, you know, whatever they're feeling at the time.
And that's where we'll leave our chat with Alfie Boe for the time being. More in the next 15 minutes, when it does take something of a sinister turn, does our conversation. Something that's never happened to me before. Coming up, BBC Newcastle through the afternoon. Saturday, 29th of November 2014, Alfie Boe comes to the North East. Actually, the start of his tour at the arena in Newcastle. It was my pleasure to talk to Alfie earlier this morning. And we're listening to that now on our show. There's one song that he just does so well, and it always gives me the goosebumps. It's a bit of Les Mis.
God on high, hear my prayer.
Yeah, well, I can't not. You know, I'll be probably hung, drawn and quartered if I didn't.
That's what,
you know,
I meant before when I said, are there certain songs that, you know, you are expected to sing in the nicest possible
right.
way?
Oh, right, yeah. No, I will be obviously doing Bring Him Home, which I've sung it a few times. You know, I did it live on radio the other day, and I was singing away and I forgot the words, and it was just at the split second that they came back to me. And I've sung that song so many times, you just get a bit of, you know, it's incredible how sometimes the words disappear, you know.
I can't sing at all, but I do like to sing that song in the car as a vocal warm-up.
No, you really can't sing, can you? Dude, that's terrible.
Sorry. Give me a lesson, would you? God on high, hear my... No,
you please see? Stop it now.
I haven't got it. Please stop it.
I think your viewers, your listeners are turning off now.
They want you to sing a bit.
Oh, you're really pushing for it now, aren't you?
Please.
Okay. Okay, here we go.
God on high.
It's too early.
Wow. Too early, he says. It sounds pretty good to me. Mind you, after that effort, after that effort from me.
I could have sung one of your favourite songs. I believe you like Alphaville Forever Young.
How the heck do you know that?
Oh, man, I know a lot about you, dude. There you go with that. You know.
I don't get that. How do you know that? That's flipping. That's bizarre. Forever
An
Young.
An Associates, Party Fears.
Two.
Party Fears 2.
You know that one? Do you know that one?
I know that one, yeah.
I had a show and phoned my brother up.
Again, less with the singing.
Leave the singing.
Sorry.
The Alphaville Alphaville song, Forever Young, that is a great song. Do you know that one?
It is. It is a great song. It's a wonderful
track. You could do that. It's very, I suppose anthemic might be the word that springs to mind.
It is a good song.
Have you just Googled me? Is that what you've done?
Me? Would I Google you?
I'm just thinking back. I'm sure at one point, so I've had a conversation where someone says, "What's your favourite song and what's your first record ever bought?" And that's probably,
Lonely Boy,
Andrew Gold.
Your favourite TV character is Columbo.
Yes,
according to Google. No, I like to know who I'm talking to. You know what I mean?
You haven't got a picture of me there, surely?
I have. Yeah, and it's pretty shocking, dude.
Thank you.
Say.
Thank you very much,
Logie.
Thank you. He knows my nickname. Let's get back to you. As an outsider looking at your career, one would think that, you know, it's all been plain sailing. Maybe it, you know, when people don't understand, you were hitting all the right notes. But did you go through a period of uncertainty at one point? Have I got that right?
Yeah, I think everybody has a point in the career where they start sort of second guessing what they're doing, and thinking, is it all worth it and is it going to work? And but that's just human nature. I think, you know, there's an element of fear with every sort of journey that you're on to an extent. But the strongest element is the trust element, is believing that it's going to happen, and that I think outweighs the fear sometimes. You know, so you've got to believe even harder that it's going to work than fear that it's not.
You know, before when you were saying, I don't actually, you know, particularly like being called an opera singer. We look at last year's album, Storyteller, and the new one, and there is a definite change in direction. Was that a conscious thing that you thought, actually, I don't just want to do this, I want to do other stuff?
It wasn't really a conscious thing. It was just a natural thing. It just came about naturally, really. It all spans from me growing up and what I used to listen to as a kid, you know, what my parents used to play on the radio, on the radio and the record player. You know, I grew up listening to Elvis records, Glenn Miller, Frankie Lane, Slim Whitman, people like that, and the classic singers like Caruso and Gigli and Tauber and people like that. So I grew up with all this vast musical education, and it just seemed to fit with me as a singer, you know, fit with me vocally, and it just became natural to start incorporating songs that were a little unusual for me. I'd do a full night of classical music, and then as an encore I'd do something completely different, you know, which is, you know, I had to go and do an interview the other day, interviewing another singer. And it was Montserrat Caballé who sang with Freddie Mercury.
Of course. And Barcelona,
And I got to chat with her, and she was talking about her recital that she did at the Royal Opera House when Freddie Mercury turned up and watched her. She sang a full evening of Italian song, German song, Spanish song. And then for an encore, she did this Freddie Mercury track, a Freddie Mercury song that he'd written for her. And it's incredible that she could stand on the Royal Opera House stage and do that, and not be affected or bothered or troubled by anybody questioning why she was doing what she was doing. Because to be honest, she was a big star back in the day and could do whatever the hell she liked, really.
I believe that she likes Forever Young by Alphaville particularly.
I think she likes
Lonely
that,
Boy by Andrew Lonely Boy.
She's actually put Spanish words to that, I think.
There's a thought for the next album. You take obscure 80s tracks and give them a new twist, Alfie Boe. I'll look forward to that one. See you on the 29th of November in Newcastle.
Give my regards to Gosforth, okay?
Oh, he knows where I live.
That's creepy too, isn't it?
Alfie Boe on the show.
Cheers, man.
He knows where I live, but he can't pronounce it properly. Gosforth, my friend. No one likes a show-off. Alfie Boe, top man. Here's something from his new album.
When you're down and troubled and you need a helping hand, nothing, oh, nothing is going right. And think of me. Soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest nights. You just call out my name. Friend. If the sky above you should turn dark and full of clouds, that old north wind should begin.
Touch of the Roger Whittakers about that.
Winter, spring, summer, or fall.
If I were a rich man.
Sorry, I'm singing again. I can't help myself. Call. Alfie Boe, you got a friend.
And I'll be there. Hey, ain't it good to know you've got a friend?